Hello students, how are you all? I hope you all are fine. In last class we started with chapter number 3, that is government. Today I am going to continue with the same chapter, right? We stopped over here, that is functions of government. So we have already studied what are the functions of government and how does the government functions and how, what are the important things which government needs to take care of, right? So today we are going to study about the importance of government, right? Why do we need government, or why is government important? So the government is necessary to ensure that the law in see that the law is same for everyone. So the first thing that the government needs to do is that they need to make laws in such a way that it should make equality for everyone. The laws should be same for everyone. It frames laws and sees that it is implemented by the concerned authorities and the police. So laws are seen and it is and that is implemented by the concerned authorities and the police. So the laws which is framed is to be followed or should be implemented by the concerned authorities, which means some important authorities and the police. A very important function of government is to make rules and regulations. So the main important function of government is they have to make rules and regulations. Whenever there is a public gathering, the government thus plays a vital role in maintaining law, order and peace, and also ensures the development of the nation. So whenever there is gatherings, public gatherings, the government needs to make sure that there is peace and non-violence, and they should protect the people, and also they should ensure the development of the nation. They should think about, the government should always think about the development of nation, right? Now the next is different levels of government, or the government at different levels. So basically the government is responsible for providing various facilities in different fields. So government needs to take care about the all the aspects, and they need to see about all the different fields or different facilities. They have to provide all the facilities in different fields. How does the government arrange for all this? How is this government managing all these things? So basically India is a vast country. If the administration was centralized, many problems would arise and cause inconvenience to the citizens and be inconvenienced. So see, as we all know that India is a very vast country, that is very big country, so it would be very difficult to manage all the states or all the whole India by one administration or by one leader, right? So this thing is very inconvenient, right? This would make many problems and there would be many inconvenience to the citizen. This could cause inconvenience to the citizens. Therefore our government works at different levels: local level, state level and national level. See, so they had made different governments, that is at state level as well as at local level, right? So this local level government is concerned with the affairs of villages and cities. So for example it's a matter of Surat, right? So we would not go and complain the PM of our India, right? So we have a local authority, right, who is taking care of our area or who is managing our area. So that goes in a level, right? So the things, or if there is any problem, you would not directly go to the heads, but you will go first at your local government, and then that complaint would be gone to the state level, right? So if they can solve the problem, the local government can solve the problem, then that would be sorted over there. So the heads, that is the state government and the central government, could look after different important issues, right? So this is the reason why they have made such a grouping or such a distribution of government. So at local level, the local level government is concerned with the affairs of villages and cities. So there is a local government who takes care about our area and our city, our village or our city. Then there is a state level government which deals the matters of the state level, while the government of the national level is responsible for the work related to the entire nation. So if there would be problem or there would be any issues regarding the state government has given the responsibility or the powers to handle the situation, and they have the responsibility to tackle the problem. And then the national level government looks only after the decisions regarding the entire nation. And the national level government is responsible for the work related to the nation only. They don't interfere in the matters of states and the local villages or cities, because they have many different departments as well to handle, right? So you have already studied about the local level, and we'll learn about the state government in the next unit. In the next class, you will learn about the national government, that is the central government, which is also called as union government. So here I'm going to stop. In our next class, we are going to study about the national government, that is the central government. Thank you. Then our next topic is the government and law. The government frames laws, and they must be obeyed by all the citizens. So over here, the government are making laws, and that laws should be obeyed by all the citizens. Law and order is very important for the proper functioning of the government. As we all know, if there won't be any rules and regulations, it would be whole mess. Everything would be mess, and that would be very difficult. So therefore the government makes different rules and regulations for different departments and different organizations, and this thing is very important for the proper functioning of our nation. The government has the authority to make as well as implement laws. So the government also has the right or the power to make different laws and to implement that as well. Now we are going to take one example of how the government makes laws. See, if you must have a ticket while traveling by train, right? You all must know that while traveling by train, you should have your ticket. If you are caught traveling without a ticket, you have to either pay a penalty or go to jail, right? So that is a law by the government, that if you don't have the train tickets, you are not allowed to travel in the train. And if you are caught without ticket while traveling, so you have to either pay penalty or go to jail. You have to suffer the punishment because you are not following the rules. Even though the government may work lawfully in case citizens feel that laws are not being executed properly. So if the government makes work lawfully in case the citizen feels that laws are not being executed properly, they have the right to raise their voices or even go to the court. See, suppose if a citizen is feeling that this laws are not being followed or this law is not correct, then the citizen has also the right to go to court and fight against that law. The court can order the government to take the appropriate measures. And the court, what will the court do? The court will tell the government or give them order to take the appropriate measures to solve the citizen's problem. The court will order the government to solve the problem, right? One more, a small example which I can give you is, for example, if a school has certain rules, right? If a school has a rule that a student should reach before 7 o'clock in the school, right? So this is the rule of our school. So if a student breaks any of the laws, then what will the school do? They will punish you for the breaking of rule, that right? Same way, the government makes certain laws, rules and regulations. If a citizen breaks that rules and regulations, they have to suffer the punishment or the penalty. They have to either pay fine or go to jail, right? So this is how the government law functions, right? So here I'm going to stop with our session. Thank you so much for listening. Bye.